Army Rangers have a proud history. Since the 1700s, Rangers have led the way in every major confrontation in which the United States has been involved. You men are credit to that fine heritage, and I'm sorry to see you go. But you've served your country well, and you've displayed the ability to fight on to the Ranger objective and complete its mission. Never leaving behind a fallen comrade, no matter what the odds or the enemy. I thank you. America thanks you. And I wish you luck wherever you go. And remember, Rangers lead the way.
My buddies around.
Hey, Cameron, no, it ain't worth it. Hey. Come on, Daddy, let's dance.
Oh, man, chicken shit. Because of pussies like you, we lost Vietnam, I'll tell you that.
You don't need trouble.
Oh, you should be so proud.
You know, for a second there, you were that guy again.
I know.
I was hoping maybe the army would make that guy grow up.
Ah! he's dead. Cameron, this guy's dead.
Admit the facts and enter plea bargain.
I will not plead guilty.
You could get 10 years. Admit to it. You get 4. Serve maybe a year.
Cameron Poe, you have pleaded guilty to manslaughter in the first degree. With your military skills, you are a deadly weapon and are not subject to the same laws as other people that are provoked because you can respond with deadly force. It is the order of this court that you be remanded to a federal penitentiary where you shall remain incarcerated for a term not less than 7 to 10 years.
Dearest Tricia, I think of you always. Your smile, your laugh. I'm not angry. The blame's gotta fall on me. I am, however, torn apart when I think that I won't be there to see our child come into the world, cradled in your arms, and her first smile. I got your package. Those pink coconut things have made me quite popular. Met a guy just the other day, Baby-O. He sure does love him. And now our daughter, beautiful Casey. I watch her grow in the pictures you send. I showed him to Baby-O. His reaction was simple. He said, thank God she looks like a mama. I'd have to agree. It's funny, but here I am. In maybe the worst place on earth, and yet somehow I feel like the luckiest man alive.
Dear Daddy, I started today at the Little Sunshine Daycare Center. My teacher is Miss Gordon. She's nice. We go to playtime, and we all have to hold hands when we walk there.
Dear Casey, it was so good to read your letter. I'm glad you like your teacher. We don't exactly have a playtime like you. We do go outside, though, but normally we don't hold hands.
My wife and I will have our margaritas on the yacht.
Mi esposa y yo vamos a tomar unas margaritas en el yate, por favor.
Today was my first day at first grade. I didn't like it. I don't want to go back tomorrow. This boy, Scotty Dalton, has black teeth and calls me names. Mama says I have to go back. Tell her not to make me.
Dear Casey, hopefully this finds you still going to the first grade. School is very important. Your mom is right. Now don't you worry about little Scotty Dalton. Sometimes you meet people like that, but don't let them get you down.
Dear Daddy, are you ever coming home?
Dear Casey, of course I'm coming home. But just a little while longer and all the things we miss doing together, you can be sure we'll do. Dear Hummingbird, break out the fine china, chill the lemonade, tie a yellow ribbon around the old oak tree, cause this boy's coming home to his ladies, coming home forever. I just hope I'm not a disappointment to Casey or to you. Love, Cameron.
My daddy's coming home on July 14th. My birthday is July 14th. I'm going to see my daddy for the first time ever on July 14th. I can't wait to meet you, honey. Isn't that the cutest thing you ever heard?
Yeah, man.
Hey, what is this?
I can't see my little daughter on her birthday without bringing her a gift now, can I?
Yeah, man, but that's a bunny rabbit.
It's all right. I mean, she'll like it, right? I mean, what? It's either this or a
tube of toothpaste and 2 packs of Pall Malls at the canteen.
That's a present.
I remember that on your birthday.
Yeah, you do that, man. It having been made to appear to the United States Parole Commission, Cameron Pope is eligible to be paroled. She might be a long time if I see something like that with my name on it.
You'll get your date someday, baby, huh?
I ain't worried about that, man.
Yeah, but like at this new prison you're going to, who's gonna watch your back?
God's got my back. You know what I'm saying?
I'm going home, son!
Man, don't be getting all juicy on me, all right? Get up.
Marshal Service annually flies 155,000 prisoners around the country for transfers, legal hearings, and medical exams. As you know, today's flight is a special one, populating Alabama's Felton Penitentiary, the newest supermax facility in the system. This place was designed to warehouse the worst of the worst. Now, most of these guys are lifers, some on death row. Pure predators, each and every one of them.
Hey, lady.
Lady's a dog in a Walt Disney movie. My name is Bishop, Guard Bishop to you.
I gotta be getting my shot before we go getting on some airplane, Guard Bishop.
What's your name?
Odell. They didn't give me my shot last night.
Okay, you're diabetic. All right, your insulin's on board. We'll give it to you in flight. Cameron Poe.
Yes, ma'am.
You know, you're still under full restraints to your process and release from your original prison, understand?
Yes, ma'am. As long as I make it home on time, that makes no never mind. It's my daughter's birthday.
Well, congratulations.
I got locked down 3 months before she was born. She ain't never seen me.
And why not?
No way was she gonna meet her daddy in a prison visitor room surrounded by homemade cookies and love-starved murderers. No way.
What you got here is a walking, talking reason to rehabilitate.
So today, let's exemplify our three operative words. Firm, fair, and vigilant. Now let's go to work.
We offload 6 in Carson City, the rest are shooting Felton.
Good. Let's go deal with the DEA boys.
You know this guy? Haven't had the pleasure.
He's a piece of work, a real piece of work.
Rocky, good to see you. She sure is beautiful.
Hey, beautiful. Sunsets are beautiful. Newborn babies are beautiful. This is fucking spectacular.
Duncan, this is Vince Larkin. He's overseeing the transport. Vince, Duncan Malloy, DEA.
Nice to meet you. I'm sure we're gonna have a good time working on this together.
Son of Eduardo, prime mover of narcotics from Colombia.
It's gonna be an all-star flight.
This kid's a potential fount of information about the family business.
11 and a half, okay?
Yeah. Look at him. Nice college boy, right? We interrogated him for months. He gave up nothing. This is our last chance before the FBI gets him. Over my dead buddy, those assholes got the glory.
We pick up Mr. Sandino in Carson City. From Benton until the plane hits Alabama, we've got 2 hours to get him to talk. We got you a seat right next to him. He's known to be somewhat garrulous in the company of thieves.
Garrulous? What the fuck is garrulous?
That would be loquacious, verbose, effusive. How about chatty?
What's with dictionary, boy?
Thesaurus boy, I think, is more appropriate.
You got your gun?
Yeah.
Whoa, gun.
We got rules, gentlemen.
Yeah, so do we. Our agents go armed.
No one carries on this flight. I got a small arsenal in the belly of the plane, a pistol in the cockpit lockbox. That's it. Other than that, we keep the plane like a prison. No weapons on the aircraft, period.
My man does not get on that plane without his gun.
Then your man doesn't get on the plane.
Okay, we'll give it to him. Give him the gun.
Avoid eye contact.
I got it.
Independence is a sign of aggression.
Larkin. I got it.
Okay. We told you today's flight would be special. That's William Bedford, a.k.a. Billy Bedlam.
Mass murderer?
The same. He caught his wife in bed with another man, left her alone, drove four towns over to his wife's family's house, killed her parents, her brothers, her sisters, even her dog.
Scan him!
And who is that good-looking brother on screen?
Nathan Jones, a.k.a. Diamond Dog. Former general of the Black Guerrillas. He blew up a meeting of the National Rifle Association saying, and I quote, they represented the basest negativity of the white race. He wrote a book in prison called Reflections in a Diamond Eye. New York Times called it a wake-up call for the black community. They're talking to Denzel for the movie. One's done it all. Kidnapping, robbery, murder, extortion.
Lodge gun, Charlie. Perimeter is secure. You are clear to release.
His name is Cyrus Grissom, a.k.a. Cyrus the Virus. 39 years old, 25 of them spent in our institutions. But he's bettered himself inside, earned 2 degrees, including his Juris Doctor. He also killed 11 fellow inmates, incited 3 riots, and escaped twice. Likes to brag that he killed more men than cancer.
Okay, open wide. Lift your tongue.
Cyrus is a poster child for the criminally insane. He's a true product of the system.
What's that supposed to mean? What is he, one of these sociology majors that thinks we're responsible for breeding these animals?
No, but I could point a few fingers if it would make you feel comfortable.
Well, now look at this walking penis. Boy, you are one skinny Negro.
Easy, man.
Open up. Oh, man, it smells like someone shit in your mouth.
Told me he loved me.
Get out of my face.
All right.
Yeah. Hey, look, who's that guy?
That is Cameron Poe, a parolee hitching a ride home. He's a nobody.
Okay, let's do it.
Willie, nobody on the plane knows your classification. Not even my guards.
Guard Bishop?
Hey, Larkin.
Tell me, Skip. Is the U.S. Marshal Service in the habit of employing annoying, wise-ass bookworm creeps?
Larkin's one of the best we got.
Yeah, well, I still like to crush his larynx with my boot.
Scan him! Face me!
What's this shit? It's my daughter.
I don't care if it's a weeping mama. Christ, there's no personal possessions on this airplane.
Just as long as you know I'll be getting that back at some point.
Are you telling me what I'm gonna be doing here, numbnuts?
You heard me.
Hey. Come on, break it up.
Oh, now look at this fashion statement. Do-rag gotta go, homeboy.
Right here.
Attention officers. Final check, all restraints.
sweet bird of freedom.
Take off in 3 minutes.
What's up, man? Oh, shit, what's up? I thought you were someone else. Pinball Parker, armed robber, arsonist, dope fiend. Well, I'm a hell of a nice guy. Just got caught.
Oh, shucks.
Right, face me.
I got it.
Open. You guys are late for the party. Okay.
Go, sweetheart.
What's up, Cochise?
Ow.
Hey, man, I'm just fucking with you, right? Don't get all wounded knee on me and shit. Look like you want to scalp a nigga.
What you looking at, punk?
Nothing, I was just admiring your cage. Fits you pretty good.
Well, welcome aboard. My, as I look around, I see a lot of celebrities among us. I see 11 current affairs, 2 hard copies, and a genuine Geraldo interviewee. But I gotta tell you, gentlemen, none of this impresses me. Because we have rules on this aircraft, and they're gonna be enforced. It's a lot like kindergarten. You'll keep your hands to yourself, you keep the decibel level down, and if any of you should feel the need to scream, spit, or bite, you get the treatment. Fuck you, pig. Gag and bag this Nazi muffin. See, this kind of thing puts me in a foul mood.
These rules will be enforced. Yes, I can't have trouble if any of you so much as passes gas in my direction. It offends my delicate nasal passages. Your testicles will become my personal property.
It's pretty clear.
Good.
Usted es el famoso criminal, amigo.
Sí, mi dice el Juanillo 23.
Tú eres Juanillo 23, sí te conozco. 23 cargos de violación.
Mira, un corazón para cada mis 23 marranitas. Call me Johnny 600 if they knew the truth.
Yeah, it doesn't have quite the same ring to it. Anyway, I despise rapists. For me, you're somewhere between a cockroach and that white stuff that accumulates at the corner of your mouth when you're really thirsty. But in your case, I'll make an exception.
Guard Falzon?
What?
Oh, stewardess. Stewardess? What's the in-flight movie today?
Well, I think you'll like it, Cyrus. It's called I'll Never Make Love to a Woman on the Beach Again. And is preceded by the award-winning short, No More Steak for Me, Ever.
Funny fucker, aren't you?
Hope this goes smoothly. All those monsters on one plane.
Please, Ginny, this is a well-oiled machine. The only thing we gotta worry about is stale peanuts and a little turbulence.
Close forward gate!
Thank you.
my shot.
Coming, coming. Left arm.
Hey, Chief, would you come through this all right? Hope you don't hold a grudge.
The fuck are you doing?
Where is it?
She's reporting in the rear cabin.
First, I thought he was singing YMCA in the plane.
But everything's under control. Say it, or I will kill you.
Without me, you got nobody to fly the plane.
I never think that far ahead.
All right, I'm doing it. Just take it easy.
And if you say a word about this over the radio, the next wings you see will belong to the flies buzzing over your rotting corpse.
Carson City.
Gun on board. Welcome to Con Air.
What happened?
Roger that, Carson City. Calm down, Vince. Just a little ruckus and the pilot hit the alarm.
Just a little ruckus?
Pilot just checked in. Everything's fine. Transponder's confirmed. And there's your baby.
Damn, this pig is heavy. Oops.
We let you out, you gonna play nice, Billy?
Probably not.
I got a spot on my arm just for you.
Hey, man, yo, come on, get off my
medication.
I'm sorry, man,
it's just
in my way.
I'm gonna use your whole body to make me feel
all right,
good.
Man, come on. All right, man, stop rushing.
No.
Oh.
You know what I am.
Ugly all day. This ain't happening. Not here. Not now.
What's happening?
Hey! Relax, he's right. Not here, not now.
Do you fly, Johnny?
No. You keep that in mind when you look at her, because if your dick jumps out of your pants, you jump out of this plane. What are the numbers in Carson City? How many on, how many off?
6 off and 10 on.
Find the 6.
Well, I know 3 of these brothers. They're right back there. The other 3 are Benson, Carls, and Popovich.
Where are they?
It's a damn good question, Cyrus, and I'm gonna find out.
Pilot wants to know what's next.
He's to land at Carson City Airport as scheduled.
Carson City? The law is down there. You lost your mind?
According to my last psych evaluation. Yes. Diamond Dog, if you would.
You think you're free?
You're not. Now listen up.
40 to 50 U.S. prison guards armed with shotguns are waiting for us at the next stop. Now if you do exactly what we tell you, the rest of our lives will be a vacation in a non-extradition country. I'm talking sandy beaches, umbrella drinks, and dirty naked freaks.
Who's doing the paying?
Our employer, Francisco Sandino.
Everybody freeze! Oh, no, Cyrus, no! Get that ass out of here right now!
Within a second.
Right now!
Keep cool, boss.
Shut up. Who the fuck are you? Yeah, that's the fuck I am.
Now, you were saying?
Well, that's very clever, Cyrus. So you think I give a shit about that little bitch guard you have there right now? Maybe you didn't hear what I said. I'm DEA, you know what the fuck that means?
You're the most crooked nigga on this plane.
Shut up.
You're DEA, what are you doing on this flight? Won't they fly you boys commercially?
Don't push me, Cyrus, man. I swear to God, I'll blow your little boyfriend right now.
You know, the next time you choose a human shield, you're better off not picking a 2-bit Negro crackhead.
Hey!
Shut up.
Quiet, sweetheart.
I think you should just stop.
Stay back, man. Stay back!
Just stop right before somebody gets killed.
Back!
All right, cowboy, I'm back.
Stay back!
You know you're in a situation you can't control, right?
I can't control it? I can't control it?
You did me.
Shut the fuck up!
My name? Yeah. Well, nice work, well, truly nice work.
Nice going, son. Not only did you not save this dude's life, you done made best friends with Cyrus the damn virus.
Hey, Cyrus, I got some good news and I got some bad news.
Yeah, what's the good news?
Well, the good news is I found Benson, Carls, and Popovich.
What's the bad news?
Bad news is this dead fella right here happens to be Benson. This Aryan fella with a bullet hole in his forehead is Carls, and this honky he's dragging in is Popovich. I don't know how to tell you this, Cyrus, but we are 3 white guys short. Or as they say in the Bionix, we be fucked. Look, man, just wanna know, alright? You didn't mean that dirty nigga crackhead shit, did you?
You mean that gun? Hell yes, I meant it. Listen,
Carson City is expecting 6 men to get off this plane, and we're going to give them exactly what they expect. So I need 3 volunteers.
Come on, let's go, son.
Don't look at me, pal.
What about her?
I'm serving 8 consecutive life sentences. I am not getting off this
plane. I got my insulin, all right, but they broke all the damn needles. And if I don't get my shot in the next couple of hours, somebody gonna be sending flowers to my mother.
I'm too old for this shit.
No offense.
Take care of myself.
I can see that.
Go ahead, go to the back. Anybody else?
Hey, right here, man. Us too.
Right. Go ahead, go to the back. Hey, whoa, stop. The guys they're expecting are white. That puts you shit out of luck.
Hey, come on, man.
I'll tell you what, sit down. One of my associates will bring you a phone book and you call the affirmative action office. You, go ahead.
Yeah, that's it. I'm gone, man. I'm dead in 2 hours. Now,
I'll get off. I'll scream to high heaven. This plane won't leave Carson City.
We need another white boy to volunteer.
Pilot's white.
Wait. The pilot. Who's gonna fly the plane?
Relax, Billy. Welcome to the machine. You rang?
Carson City says we got a hell of a sandstorm down there.
Ha! Perfect.
Crazy.
Cyrus Grissom.
Got scratches on the wall. Probably weapon sharpening.
What about the loose shell screw?
What the hell is this?
Looks like cocaine.
What do you got, some there?
I don't know. It's all soft.
What about the rest of the pigs?
Be patient now. They haven't ceased to be useful yet.
Okay, old man, now you're Mr. Popovich.
Gentlemen, you'll reach the Nevada Pen in about 2 hours. The tape's just a little precaution in case any of you are rocked by the sudden impulse to squeal like a pig. Not that we would trust you, but let's face it, you're criminals.
Come on, man, move your head up.
I want to stay on.
What?
Changed my mind.
So, Cyrus, we got a little mind changer.
I got 15 years left, and I know I'd just hate myself if I thought I blew my one shot at a naked party freak and an umbrella drink.
You got 15 years? Boy, a second ago, you couldn't wait to get off this plane.
I know. Feel freedom, I guess.
Get him up, get the cuffs up. Pick out a guard and then put that dead cop's prison issues on him.
What the hell are you doing?
Staying. They're gagging everybody for the bus ride to the Pen. It'll be hours before the feds discover what happened. By then, you'll be dead. So will she.
Oh, think of your little girl.
Now, what would my daughter think of me if I let you like this to get this arm and die?
You keep acting like you're still a ranger, we're all gonna be in trouble. You're not that guy anymore, you're a convict.
Told you I'd get that back.
Fuck you, trailer trash.
Hey, my mama lives in a trailer. And put those on. I'll just save your life.
Okay, soldier boy, you got a plan?
Maybe.
I got a lot of weird shit down.
What is it?
This looks like the drawing of a plane.
Who sent us that? The virus.
Trash, no.
That's right.
Thank you.
skinny little man butchers 30-something people up and down the eastern seaboard. They say the way he kills those people makes the Manson family look like the Butcher's family.
Well, he's on the right flight.
But you know what? You really do
Tammy,
need to leave.
You got the prettiest eyes I've seen in about 5 to 10 years. Meet cars where? Carson City. Oh, God. Stay here. Don't touch anything.
So what are you doing?
Just leave it alone. I told you not to touch anything.
Code Red, Code Red, Starkey, those guards ain't guards, they're cons. Stall them.
Christ. This is going to be a day you will never forget. Just step right on board and find yourself a seat.
Don't they have a way of tracking these planes?
Oh, yeah, it's called a transponder. Every plane's got one, Cendino.
Smoke, where is the transponder?
Where indeed?
All right.
are you sure it's safe to fly in this?
No problem. I've done this 1,000 times. We'll be through this in a few minutes. You all right back there, ladies?
We're following the transponder. We know exactly where they're heading.
What the fuck happened? What about Sims? What happened to Sims?
Duncan. They killed him.
They got the plane.
Tell me, Skip. What kind of a Keystone Cops operation you guys running here, huh? And you little shit, you got my agent killed.
Hey! He brought a gun on the plane. If I knew the way you guys run things, I was gonna bring a fucking Uzi on board.
No one carries on these flights. No one. He brought a gun on board and he got himself killed. And in doing so, he compromised the safety of my men.
Your men are incompetent. They let themselves get taken over by a bunch of thugs and chains and cages.
I'm not gonna stand around and listen to this shit.
Guys, let's work it out.
So, what are we doing now? What's the plan? You do have a plan, don't you?
We're working on it. Contingency plans for something like this don't exist. The situation's never been contemplated.
Well, you better start contemplating, because this is a situation that needs to get unfucked right now! I want a chopper. Make that a fuel. I need to be armed. I don't care if it's National Guard, Air Force, whatever. Just get in here and get in here now.
What do you want to do with him?
I don't know, but this is no way to treat a national treasure. Let him out.
You sure?
Love your work.
They're headed southeast toward Arizona.
Pinball didn't make it.
No? That's too bad. I like pinball.
What do you want?
I want to know what the plan is.
Why you care?
I got just as much riding on this as you. We all convicts here.
Cyrus Grissom, do you copy? Cyrus Grissom, do you copy?
Yes, I copy. Identify yourself.
This is United States Marshal Vince Larkin, Duncan Malloy of the DEA.
Oh, Agent Malloy. I'm so sorry about your associate. Nothing is quite as sad as seeing a grown man pissing his pants.
Listen, Grissom, you puny fucking animal! When I get through with you, you'll be begging him for the electric chair!
Hey! I don't like him! If he speaks again, this conversation is terminated.
He doesn't want to talk again. Really. He's done talking. He's leaving the building, okay?
Good, then I'll talk to you. Here are the rules. First I ask a question, then you ask a question.
Okay, what's your question?
In Carson City, your bulls were onto us. How?
One of the guards faked a heart attack and we had to remove his restraints. All right?
I see. And what's your question?
Where are you going with my plane, Cyrus?
We're going to Disneyland.
You're lying, Cyrus.
So are you, Vince. Oh, nothing makes me sadder than the agent lost his bladder in the airplane. Lerner Airfield, Poe, middle of nowhere. That's our rendezvous point. 49 minutes from anything resembling authority. So, now you know.
Your attention, please.
like 475 excited.
Mm-hmm.
You sure look pretty.
Mrs. Poe?
That's right.
My name's Grant, U.S. Marshal Service. There's been a slight problem on your husband's flight. Your presence is requested. I have a jet standing by.
Yeehaw! So on your mind, hillbilly?
What was I thinking about? Oh yeah, yeehaw, that's right. I was just wondering what a black militant, that would be you, was doing taking orders from a white boy on a power trip. Don't you think that's strange?
It's a means to an end, my white friend. A means to an end. See, eyes can play house nigga till we get to where we're going. And then, the day of the dog begins. So what was that all about?
Oh, nothing. Except they somehow managed to get every creeping freak in the universe onto this one plane. And then somehow managed to let them take it over. And then somehow managed to stick us right smack in the middle. Hi, Garland.
Here's the jacket on Cameron Poe. His wife's on the way here now. U.S. Ranger. Highly decorated. Did a little hell-raising when he was a kid, but nothing serious.
Explain to me why any of this matters.
Fact one, we got a plane up there filled with killers, rapists, and thieves, and we got this guy, Cameron Poe. In on an involuntary manslaughter beef, non-gang affiliated. He's a parolee hitching a ride home. Fact two, Poe has a chance to get off the plane. Doesn't do it. Fact three, our guard Falzon said a convict named Cameron Poe planted Sims tape recorder on him. These are interesting facts. You do the math on this, and we got an ally on that plane.
Ally?
This guy is a criminal, a murderer. Read the file. Got in a drunken brawl defending his wife, and he killed a guy. Could have happened to any one of us, including you and me.
I am not one of these animals.
Oh, that's original. When exactly did they all become animals?
When they stopped giving a damn about the law, about civilization.
The degree of civilization in a society can be judged by observing its prisoners. Dostoevsky said that after doing a little time.
Fuck you. Cyrus Grissom said that after putting a bullet in my agent's head, okay?
The issue here is how the plane is brought down.
Shoot it down.
When exactly did this become a DEA jurisdiction?
The second the DEA agent was murdered, I am authorized to bring Agent Sims killers to justice using, and I quote, all necessary means.
That does not include shooting down my plane.
Maybe it does, maybe it doesn't.
Is that right? Tell me you're not seriously entertaining this.
Sims, this is a drastic situation we got.
Those are our men up there!
All of whom signed the no hostage clause. They know the score.
Who are you to decide the value of a man's life? There are innocent people up there.
About time.
For what? About time for what?
Attack choppers. We're going after them.
God damn it! Damn, don't do this! This man is in a rational state of mind! His head is not strong! Fuck off, Marshal Larkin. Your job's finished. This fight's full.
Gentlemen, in roughly 5 hours, we will be flying over the shores of Mexico, but first we have to change aircraft. Thank you, and have a pleasant flight. What's the ETA, Swampman?
At 228 miles an hour by 71 minutes. The only problem is we're not doing 228 miles an hour, we're doing 205. We're dragging, baby. The landing gear ain't all the way up. We're gonna be late.
No, Cyrus, that's unacceptable.
Check out the gear.
The hell do I know about landing gear?
Learn.
Well, I'll get to see some nice scenery with them there down there. Trees and stuff.
See, there were 160 cats on North Block, and I didn't want to know 159 of them, which included you. What do you think about that?
Yeah. He's a font of misplaced rage. Name your cliche. Mother held him too much or not enough. Last pick that kicked ball, late night sneaky uncle, whatever. Now he's so angry, moments of levity actually cause him pain. Gives him headaches. Happiness for that gentleman hurts.
What's wrong with him?
My first thought would be a lot.
Mm-hmm. Hello, Casey.
Hello, Mr. Casey.
Nice to meet you. So, how are you? You doing? I'm sorry, that's a scratch that dumb question. You wanted to see your husband today, and then this whole thing happened.
Maybe you could just tell me exactly what's going on here.
We're doing everything we can to get the plane down. Actually, that's why I wanted to talk to you.
Where'd you get the ribs, man? Personal shit's down in the belly.
Hey, those are my shades.
They're mine now, sister.
men.
It seems that your husband, Cameron, had an opportunity to get off the plane and he didn't do it. And I was hoping you could maybe help me figure out why.
That would make two of us. I don't know.
I mean, it's possible. It's not uncommon that some parolees actually fear their release date. A certain degree of institutionalization sets in. Fear of coming home, fear of living in society. Any of this makes
sense? No. It's not Cameron. I mean, if you knew him, if you read his letters, or if you talked to him on the phone, you'd know that. I mean, he's been waiting for this day for 8 years. He's not gonna... Look, he's got this little girl to come home to. Wouldn't you do the same thing?
Have to be a pretty strong reason to keep me on that plane.
Well, knowing Cameron, I'm sure there is a good reason. Maybe if you do see him, or if you talk to him, maybe you could just tell him to come home, all right? It'd be kind of nice to have him around.
You got it.
Vince, lie. This body fell out of the sky.
Vince Larkin, this is Ted Grasso, Fresno Police Department. We got a problem here with a corpse. Yeah, it fell out of the sky. I don't think he's an astronaut.
And what's this got to do with me?
It's got your name written all over it.
Last transponder tag was in Arizona. Body falls here in Fresno. Lunar airfield.
They're turning around. They're coming. Can you get me a jeep?
Beavers.
Vince, turn around. Plane's headed to Lunar Airfield. This is a small strip about 100 miles from here.
Horse shit! We're tailing the transponder tag into Arizona.
Listen to me. A body fell from the sky. He had a note on it.
We got him vectored at 12 o'clock and 30 miles. Vince, please, shut! We're right on his tail!
Just listen to me! It was to me! The note on the body was to me! You're chasing the...
Shut up!
Hello? Guys, I need a plane or a chopper now.
Hey, you and me both, I'm all out.
I gotta get to Lunar Airfield. I've got about 50 minutes.
Got a fast car, you can drive it.
Larkin, Vince Larkin, I'm with the Marshal Services. Send whatever you got, Sheriff, State Trooper, National Guard. Hold on 1 minute. Your men should proceed with extreme caution. It's only a matter of time before they find the weapons hold. Larkin! Vince Larkin! Marshal Services! How do you think I got the number?
Appears the United States Parole Commission that...
back in the box.
I knew you was a punk. And I was right. You've been playing us all along. You a free man.
I said, put the bunny back in the box.
Thank you.
body back in the box.
Next, folks, below and to your left, you'll see the vertical red wall cliffs.
We're seconds away from establishing visual contact.
Holy shit!
Uncle Bob's Scenic Tours.
Shit! 300 fucking miles to apprehend Mom, Paul fucking Kevin.
We need to get to Lerner Airfield now! Get me Vince Larkin!
One came up.
Wasn't my fault.
Well, you don't have to tell me. Most murders are crimes of necessity rather than desire, but the great ones, Dahmer, Gacy, Bundy, they did it because it excited them.
Don't you... I got nothing in common with them, with you. Don't you talk to me. They were insane.
Now you're talking semantics. What if I told you insane was working 50 hours a week in some office for 50 years, at the end of which they tell you to piss off, ending up in some retirement village, hoping to die before suffering the indignity of trying to make it to the toilet on time? Wouldn't you consider that to be insane?
Murdering 30 people, semantics or not, is insane.
One girl? I drove through 3 states wearing her head as a hat.
It's my daughter's birthday today. So please feel free not to share everything with me.
Landing.
Lerner Airfield, I'm so glad to be here. Thank you for choosing Conair. Where's the plane, Francisco?
I don't know. Have patience.
The last guy told me to have patience. I burned him down and bagged his ashes.
Cyrus, it'll be here.
Like sand. Muchacho, run and check out the tower. Have a look-see, yeah?
Right.
Come on, Dallas.
Let's go. We're getting off.
I can't.
Yes, you can. Come on.
You shouldn't move him.
I'm getting him off of this plane.
You can't move him. He's too far along. He could go into shock.
Oh, she's right, Bo. Go on, man.
And I mean without you. Or you.
Oh, here we go, Ranger boy.
Right.
God damn it, Paul! Man, it's time to fight. Fuck, hit the fence. I suggest you hit the fence.
He's right. Just go.
All right, here's how it's gonna play. I'm gonna get you that needle.
Whatever you say, man, just do what you gotta do.
All right, you just hang on, don't die on me.
Swing low, sweet chariot, coming for to carry me home.
Oh, no. What the hell you think you're doing?
It's time to off the pigs.
Can't do that.
Tell me why.
They're hostages. We need them.
So why the fuck you care?
Hey, man. Come on. I can't think of a thing. I like... better than to put a bullet in the brain base of one of these fuckers. But the fact of the matter is, how well you know this Sindino? I mean, I don't know him that well myself, just what I read. Like how he firebombed that senator's yacht with two of his own cousins on board.
So what's your point?
Why would he sweat about killing some hired guns once they'd served his purpose? Now think about that.
What exactly are we discussing here?
Poe. Don't want me to off the pigs.
Well, it's not difficult to surmise how Nathan here feels about killing guards, and my own proclivities are well-known and often lamented facts of penal lore. What I'm wondering is why you have any opinion about it at all.
Cyrus, this is your barbecue, man, and it tastes good.
But I was just saying to Mr. Dog over here that if it was my barbecue, I'd wait for that old jumbo jet in the sky before I start killing our only leverage.
Shut the fuck up!
Don't you want to get high and get laid and shit?
No, fuck this!
Put the gun down. Put the gun down, Nathan. Poe's right. We're going to plan B. Gonna get a refueling truck and a tractor. So get back there and dig the plane out. Time to go and get that tractor, yeah?
Right.
I'll get the fuel truck. Thanks, Bo. Proven to be a most useful mammal.
Any hands make light work. My daddy taught me that.
You know what my daddy taught me?
What's that?
Nothing.
Seth educated me.
Reaching
him, sir.
Of course you're having trouble reaching him. He's off saving the rainforest or recycling his sandals or some shit.
Jet, you can take Sandino and leave the rest to rot for all I care. You fire that weapon, 20 pissed off prisoners are gonna hear it. Comprende, esse? Well, hooray for the sounds of fucking silence.
Freeze!
Message.
Where are the troops?
They'll be here.
They'll be here.
In a minute. Listen, Poe. Can I lower this?
Go ahead.
You gonna lower yours?
Sorry, boss. But there's only two men I trust. One of them's me. The other's not you.
So Sedino was running a drag on everyone.
Yeah.
Can't trust a South American drug lord. Who can you trust, huh? That was a joke.
I'm glad you told me. Now I gotta get back to the plane.
You're a free man, Poe. What are you doing?
I can't trade a friend's life for my own lock, and that's all.
You got a friend on board. See, I knew I was right about you. I read your file. You're not such a bad guy, just always in the wrong place at the wrong time.
Goodbye, Larkin.
I spoke to your wife!
In person?
In person. And your little girl.
You... saw Casey. If this thing goes bad, Locke, and I'm afraid my daughter won't understand. If you talk to my wife again, you tell her I love her. She's my hummingbird. But I couldn't leave a fallen man behind. You'll do that for me, won't you, Larkin?
Sure I will. What are you gonna do for me?
What do you think I'm gonna do? I'm gonna save the fucking day.
I want this airplane out now.
Thank you.
Montana. Listen, I need a syringe.
Oh, no. Drugs will end you, son.
Is there a first aid kit around here?
Well, there might be one in the fire truck over on the boneyard.
All right, thanks. You just stay here and don't panic.
It's easy for you to say. You don't gotta take a piss.
Very quick, very simple. This is the boneyard. This is the hangar. This is our plane.
What's that?
That's a rock.
Okay.
The convoy will enter the boneyard through here. Initially, we take out the first car. Then we take out the last, creating a trap, an airtight cage filled with lots and lots of dead people. Nathan, set everybody in their position, yeah? Bring me those propane tanks! Let's go, let's go. Get them in there. If they give any trouble, kill them.
What can I do?
Pick this. Go into the boneyard, yeah? Anybody gets through, you scratch their eyes out.
You got it.
No, bitch!
another day, that might seem strange.
Idiots dancing on a plane to a song made famous by a band that died in a plane crash.
Like it was me.
No, he's flipped out, man. He's nuts.
It's pretty clever, huh, bitch?
Jesus! No, that's clever!
My daddy is coming home on July 14th. My birthday is July 14th. I'm gonna see my daddy for the first time ever on July 14th.
Make a move and the bunny gets it.
Let's take him out, Logan.
Not yet! Fire!
Son, I'm feeling like maybe I'm not supposed to make it.
You're gonna make it.
Cyrus Crystal, this is Special Agent Vince Larkin. We will shoot the plane down if you do not respond now.
All I can think about is like, there ain't no God, but he don't exist. where you going?
I'm gonna show you God does exist. Put this thing down.
Target locked, sir.
Oh, yeah! Don't you do it! Don't shoot!
Don't fire.
Who is this? Identify yourself!
This is Gamma Ball.
Yes.
I repeat, target is locked, sir.
Malloy, he's got the plane!
We're not over civilian population. Now's the time, sir.
Don't fire.
Malloy, listen to him. He's afraid. He's just trying to get home to see his wife and kids. Don't fire.
Now's the time, sir.
Hold fire.
Sir?
I said hold fire.
Thank you.
Vegas Airport. It's just past the strip. Can you see it?
Well, even Las Vegas.
It's right there, man. You can make it. All the runways are cleared. Come on, do it.
Then put this thing down.
Listen here, Big Daddy. We got one engine shot to shit, zero fuel, and we're dropping too fast. The strip's where I'm gonna land. Only the word is crash.
Now civilian casualties will be enormous.
Strap in, ladies. We're going for a night out in Vegas.
Sir.
morning of, the last thing that little Casey Poe ever gets to smell will be my stinking breath.
Thank you.
them?
This is a weird thing to be on a plane full of hard asses.
You okay?
No.
Good. Glad we didn't shut it down, huh?
Oh yeah, it worked out much better this way. Listen, I apologize about the car. I know the body shop in Fresno, it's insured.
Just bored in that car, anyway.
Worked out nicely then.
Casey?
Well, does he? Yes.